To make a complete cycle of any composer is particularly interesting for me because it gives me the widest possible picture of a composer. To do it with Shostakovich, with the 15 symphonies by Shostakovich, is even more interesting because he composed the number one. He was as a graduation piece for the conservatorium. And the last one, the number 15, he composed very close to his death, the last 2 years of his death, from his death. So it just includes and is like a frame for all his life. And to explore that and having this possibility with the London Symphony Orchestra, to have the possibility to have the record to put on disc is fantastic because it's a huge journey. When I approach any kind of music, first of all, I just try to get in contact with the score because that is the word that the composer put on paper. And after that, I try to investigate, to research which period of his life or her life, of those female composers, but in which part of the composer's life that symphony has been conceived, composed, and premiered. That is also important because some symphonies they didn't get the premiere where they were just finished, but much later. It's not the case of the number seven. Also, it's a question of personal curiosity. I try to read things to discover things because of anecdotes, stories of my friends that met with either Rostropovich or Shostakovich because they were friends. So some of the stories I got to know is because some of friends of Rostropovich told me. There are some composers more famous and more popular in some countries than others, but the attitude toward classical music is not particularly different. I find enthusiasm or skepticism all over the world, but I think that's what tells me this situation, that any time I go on stage, I touch music, I make music with the artist of any orchestra, but particularly with London Symphony, talking about Shostakovich, we have to give the maximum. We have to serve the music, to let the music speak.